Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today, we are going to talk about everything related to SEBI Grade A examination. It is around the corner and therefore I felt it's important that we have a good understanding about the examination, the previous exam dates, the vacancies, the cutoffs, the kind of salary that you will be getting if you are selected, eligibility requirements, all these things and a lot more, so that we're able to make an informed and a rational decision before we decide to jump into the examination. There are a lot of students who are declared ineligible at the end when they start preparing. They don't look at it and then they realize towards the end or after some time that they are now ineligible. So it's better always to make a very rational and informed choice, as I said, before actually making such a big commitment for an examination like this. Okay, so taking that into consideration, let's start with our session wherein I will be discussing with you everything that you can think of related to SEBI Grade A examination. We'll be starting with previous exam dates and vacancies, eligibility requirements, qualification of students, exam pattern, syllabus cutoff, and we will also be talking about salaries that you can expect of getting if you're selected, salaries as well as perks. Okay, so first of all, let us start with previous exam dates and vacancies that have happened in the past. 2020 examination, which ended up happening in 2021 in the first half because of COVID, it got delayed. What were the first application dates and when was it held? The application came out on March 7, 2020. It was delayed or postponed till October 31st, 2020. And finally, the examination was held on 17th January 2021. This was phase 1. Phase 2 examination was held on 27th February. So we see a gap of almost 40 days, which is a very good gap compared to other examinations like RBI, where you normally get a gap of about 30 days. And then comes phase 3, which was interview, which started in June. Again, due to lockdown, it got postponed yet again. But it might not happen in the future if we do not have an unfortunate another wave. Okay, now coming to vacancies, number of students who were selected, the vacancies that were asked for in the year 2020 and then 2018. So you see a very strong trend, good trend and stability in the number of vacancies. In 2018, there were 84. In 2020, there were 80 general vacancies, for legal 34 and 18. So we saw a stark increase in the number of legal vacancies. It might happen in the future as well because of the number of complexities which are arising now in the capital market, especially they might need more legal experts. Okay, IT, again we see a stark increase in the number of vacancies for the same reason, but on the other hand, civil engineering, electrical engineering, we see a fall in number of vacancies. For research, again we see a new vacancy being announced. The reason is yet similar again. They need more people to do the kind of research that they need to do in order to make sure that the market is regulated well. Okay, I hope it's clear. So in the year 2021, we are expecting similar number of vacancies. Eligibility and qualifications. There are two major eligibilities, age limit and educational qualification. Let's talk about them one by one. When it comes to age limit, the maximum age limit is 30 years for a general candidate, for an unreserved category candidate. For SCST, there is a relaxation of 5 years. For OBCs, there is a relaxation of 3 years. For PWD, there is a relaxation of 10 years. And if you are a PWD plus, let's say, SCST, then the good thing is that you can combine these two relaxations and your relaxation increases to 15 years. For OBC, it is 13, and for ex-servicemen, it is 5 years. There is no relaxation for EWS category. Please remember that. Okay, there is no relaxation for any kind of experience that you might have. There is nothing that is mentioned in the notification. Okay, I hope it's clear. So this is all that we have about the age limit and the relaxation. Next comes qualification. This is very important. A lot of students fill in the exam, decide to write the exam, start their prep, and then down the line they realize that they are ineligible because of these qualifications. If you're not from the field of law, or if you're not an engineering student, then you need a master's degree in any discipline, which means that you should have finally passed and received your final result before the examination. The notification fortunately mentions the date specifically, and it says by this date your final result should have been out. That is very good, because you know specifically, okay, if I don't have the final result in my hand, then I'm ineligible. Final result does not mean degree. Please remember that. Okay. You can have the final mark sheet, plus you can get the provisional certificate from your university, and you are good to go. You don't need a degree, a specific degree, which is normally released after 3 to 5 years by a lot of universities. Okay. So you don't need a degree. You need a provisional certificate plus the final mark sheet. Marks of all the years are calculated together. That's very important. Please remember that. If you're a chartered accountant or a CFA or a CS company secretary or a cost accountant, then you don't need to have a master's degree. Please remember this, because there is an or out here. So if you're a CA and a bachelor, with a bachelor's degree, then you are very well eligible. Okay, very much eligible. Number of attempts. No number of attempts have been specified by the authorities, which is a good thing. So the moment you turn 21, let's say you've completed your master's by 22, for example, till you turn 30, you have a total of 8 to 9 years. You can write any number of attempts in these years. Okay, I hope this is clear. Very simple. Exam pattern. The exam is held in three phases: phase 1, phase 2, and phase 3. Phase 3 is the interview stage, interview phase. Phase 1, two papers of 100 marks each. We'll be talking about these two papers specifically in the future slides. Phase 2, again, two papers of 100 marks each. We'll be talking about this as well. And we'll be talking about this as well in the future slides. But just to give you an outline or a basic idea, it is held in three phases. Please remember that. Okay. Now, what happens in phase 1? As I said, there are two papers in phase 1. One paper consists of all the subjects which you are going to be asked questions from in phase 2 as well. So this is very important and very good for students. So if you are preparing for phase 2 for these 6 subjects, you are simultaneously prepared for phase 1 as well. You don't need to prepare a separate list of subjects, a separate list of topics, because there's a complete overlap, not a lot of overlap, a complete overlap between what you're going to be asked in phase 1 and phase 2 as per the syllabus. Okay, the level of question changes certainly, but the topics or the subjects remain the same. There are 50 number of questions, maximum marks 100, which means one question is of 2 mark. Okay, the time is 40 minutes for this specific section, and the minimum cutoff is 40%. If you have more than 40% in paper 2, you are through. You're through to phase 2. Combined with paper 1, of course. Let's talk about paper 1. What happens in paper 1? You will have questions from general awareness, English, quant, reasoning, as it happens in bank examination. The objective is to check your aptitude. You might have knowledge of all these subjects, but you might not have the right aptitude. Therefore, all these 4 topics are also asked. Now, how many questions and how much time? 80 questions, 80 number of questions, 100 marks, that means one question is of 1.25 mark, and 60 minutes are given combined for all these 80 questions. Okay, 20 questions from each subject. So you have 80 marks, 80 questions, 100 marks, 20 questions from each subject, 25 marks for each subject. It's very simple. The cutoff is interesting here. It's 30% and not 40%. So what you need is 3 things. Number 1, individual cutoff for paper 1 is 30. Individual cutoff of paper 2 is 40. Aggregate cutoff also needs to be 40. Let's say you have 32% here and you have 41% here. Then your aggregate cutoff is not going to be 40. It's going to be less than 40, right? You will be declared ineligible. You will be disqualified, removed from the examination. So you need at least 40% by combining these two as well. So how much do you need? For example, you have, let's say, 32% here, very less. You have, let's say, 63% here, much higher. Combined, 95 out of 200. You have more than 40. So you are eligible. You have qualified for phase 2. I hope it's clear. Combined, you need 40%. Okay. I hope this is clear. Negative marking, 1/4. So 1.25 ka 1/4 will be your negative marking. 1.25 by 4 is going to be your negative marking. Okay. You will need to secure separate cutoff. Ye maine aapko bata diya hai. Marks obtained by phase 1 in phase 1 shall be only for shortlisting applicants. Let's understand this. Whatever marks you get, let's say you scored a total of 65%. You scored an aggregate of 90%. It doesn't matter. Unless you don't have, you have less than 40%. Let's say you have 90%. This score is useless after you have qualified for phase 2. This is not going to decide your merit. Your merit is going to be decided by your scores in phase 2 and your interview, combining them together. So this is a qualifying level where they're trying to eliminate as many applicants as possible who are not fit for that post. Okay, I hope it's clear. Now comes phase 2. Again, two papers in phase 2. Paper 1 is English, which is descriptive test writing, where you need to write online on computer. So your typing skills need to improve. If they are bad, you need to make sure that you're typing okay. About 40 to 50 words per minute, you can use a typer. You can use a speed checker also. So if your speed is about 40 to 50 words a minute, that's more than enough, good enough. Okay. What is the weightage and what kind of questions are asked? 100 marks, 60 minutes, that means 1 hour. Normally for other examinations is 1.5 hour, but for this it is 1 hour. So please remember this. Cut off 30%, you need to at least have 30%, otherwise you'll be disqualified. Weightage is 1/3, we'll understand this. Now 100 marks, normally 3 questions are asked. One is your essay, one is precis, and one is comprehension. That is how normally the paper is made, the paper is set. 60 minutes, 30% is the minimum cutoff. Please remember this. Paper 2 has a total of 6 subjects. Let's start. Commerce, accounts, management, finance, costing, companies, economics. Finance, same as RBI. If you're preparing for that, you'll be prepared simultaneously. Management, same as RBI. Accounts, commerce. One second. There is a problem here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Commerce and accountancy is the same actually. That's why I got confused. Okay, 1. Commerce and accountancy. You will be preparing separately. If you're an engineer, if you're from commerce background, CA ho, MCOM kiya hai, then it'll be a cakewalk for you. But you need to revise properly. Costing, again, Companies Act and Economics. Economics mein, both micro and macroeconomics can be asked in the examination. Okay, dono hi syllabus mein diye gaye hain. Negative marking, 1/4 for this paper because this is objective. Ye to descriptive hai first wala. So negative marking nahi hoti descriptive mein. Again, 100 marks. Questions from all these areas, 40 minutes, the time is very less here. Minimum cutoff is 40%. You need to have at least 40%, otherwise you'll be disqualified. Okay. You would need to secure separate cutoff in both paper 1 as well as paper 2. 40% in phase 2. So the combined cutoff is 40%. If you don't have 40% combined, again, you'll be disqualified. This becomes irrelevant. Why? Because the cutoff normally goes very high, 66, 65, 62, something like that. So almost 60%. So if you have less than 60%, anyways, you will be disqualified. So this becomes irrelevant. Ye bas diya gaya hai. In case a student has less than 40%, he'll automatically be disqualified. Okay, I hope this is clear. I don't think I've left out anything. 100 marks, 40 minutes, 50 questions were asked in the previous year. It might change in the future, but normally this is the trend. I think this should be followed in the future as well. 50 questions of 2 marks each. That is what happened. Phase 3 interview has a weightage of 15%. Okay, one more thing that I think we missed out. The weightage thing here. How does it work? It says weightage of 1/3, weightage of 2/3. 100 marks ka hai, both of them. So combine karte hain to 200 number bante hain. So how do you divide? So what happens is, they multiply this by 2. Let's say I scored 60 here. I scored 50 here. So 6 plus 5, 110. 110 out of 200. How much is it? 55%. But what will they do? They will divide, multiply it by 2. That means 120 here, it will remain the same 50. 170 upon 300. Okay, how much is it? Less than 60%. So it is about 3 into 5, 15. 23 into 6, 18. 56% ho gaya. Yahan pe it was 55%. It has increased to 56% because the weightage of this paper has increased. It has doubled, and because you scored more here. If you score less here, your score goes down ultimately because the weightage of this is twice of what it is given here. Okay. So 2/3 now, the weightage out of this 56% that you've scored, 2/3 belongs to paper 2 and 1/3 belongs to paper 1. दैट इज हाउ दे डू इट. आई होप इट्स क्लियर. वेरी सिंपल. फेज थ्री में जाते हैं. इट हैज अ वेटेज ऑफ 15% इन द फाइनल मेरिट लिस्ट स्कोर. नॉर्मली इट इज हेल्ड ऑफ 50 मार्क्स. वो हमने कैलकुलेट किया था. 300 स्कोर बिकम्स 85%. देन 100% अगर हम बनाएंगे इसका तो इट बिकम्स समवेयर अराउंड 353. सो यू नो अप्रोक्सीमेटली 50 मार्क्स का इंटरव्यू होगा, उसमें आपको जो भी स्कोर दिया जाएगा. एंड देन दे विल कैलकुलेट द वेटेज. यू हैव एन ऑप्शन टू चूज द इंटरव्यू लैंग्वेज ईदर इंग्लिश और हिंदी बिफोर द इंटरव्यू राउंड एज पर योर कन्वीनियंस. सो डोंट थिंक कि भाई हिंदी आती है मेरे को, इंग्लिश अच्छी नहीं आती, सो आई विल बी डिसक्वालिफाइड और दे वॉन्ट लाइक मी और दे वॉन्ट पीपल फ्रॉम इंग्लिश बैकग्राउंड. देर इज नथिंग ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट बिकॉज इट्स स्पेसिफिकली मेंशनड हियर. ओके. The final merit list will be based upon the marks scored in the mains and interview round. Phase 2, as I said, plus phase 3 is going to decide your final score. Okay? 85% given to phase 2, 15% weightage given to phase 3, that is interview. Okay? Now, let's come to the syllabus. English language, this is a comprehensive list of what topics can be asked. You might not be asked all of these topics. You might be asked only, let's say, 5 of these topics. It's already covered in the course. Vocabulary ऐसी चीज है जो हम cover नहीं कर सकते. आपको सारी vocabulary तो रटवाएंगे नहीं. So of course you have to do it on your own. In the course it has been explained how can you build up your vocabulary. Similarly tenses rules cannot be taught to you. It is expected that you have a master's degree or you are a CA or you are an engineer, so you are aware about these things. If you are not, you have to build them up. That is very very important. Okay. Reading comprehension, fill in the blanks, jumbled words, rearrangements, passages, para jumbles, close test. ये सारी चीजें आपको सिखाई जाती हैं. These things are taught to you. Idioms and phrases again cannot be taught. You have to pick up a book which has let's say 100 or 1000 idioms and phrases and try and mug them up. Synonyms and antonyms similar, very similar to vocabulary, so it cannot be taught. It has to be learned on your own. That's very important. Okay. Error spotting, similar to fill in the blanks, sentence rearrangement, match the columns, phrase replacement, very overlapping with these topics, so that are taught together normally. But this is an exhaustive list of what kind of questions, what from what areas the questions can be asked from you in the exam. Okay, let's come to quant. This is an exhaustive list of all the topics that might be asked from you in the examination. You might feel that you don't need to do mensuration. You might feel that you don't need to do probability. You don't need to do, let's say, PNC if it is mentioned here. I don't think it's even mentioned. Permutation and combination, it's mentioned here. So you might feel that you don't need to do. And of course, these are normally not asked. But you might have one question from probability. Then you might panic. So you have to make sure that either you are exhaustively covered every topic or you have left out some topics which you feel have never been asked or in the past 4 years, in the past year, there was not asked in the exam. Okay. So that is something that you have to keep in mind. Normally, I say that ratio and proportion, percentage, time, speed, distance, DI, quadratic, pipes and systems, profit and loss, LCM, HCF, partnership, average, time and work, mixture and allegation, simplification, inequality, upstream, downstream, simple interest, compound interest, time, speed, distance, ages. These are normally asked in the examination. Any of these, this exhaustive list of topics. Okay. Let's come to reasoning ability now. This is again an exhaustive list. Puzzles, seating arrangement, the most popular yet the most fearful. Inequalities can be asked here. They can also be asked in quant. That's why they've been put on both the areas. Direction, blood relation, syllogism, input-output, data sufficiency, reasoning, analogy, coding-decoding, order and ranking, number series, strong weak arguments, decision-making, statement-conclusion, alphanumeric series. These are all important. They can and have been asked in the past. Okay. Let's come to general awareness. This is an exhaustive list of areas. Majority of it is covered in Spotlight. So if you pick up Spotlight, you're covering the entire current affairs. You don't need to go anywhere else. It is available on the website for free. It is available on the portal for free. You can download it, use it. It has a list of 200 plus questions also towards the end. So that is also useful. Okay. Static GK. You will find a lot of sources online. Lucent is good enough. Remember that you don't have to cover the entire Lucent. It covers geography, it covers history. वहाँ से questions नहीं आते हैं. Normally the questions are limited to banking areas. Questions are limited to very easy facts. For example, what is the capital of let's say Qatar? What is the capital of Afghanistan? These kind of basic things can be asked in the exam. Coming to phase 2 syllabus, descriptive paper, as I said, normally has 3 questions, Prezi, essay and comprehension. 60 minutes ka hai, please remember this, not 90 minutes, unlike RBI, NABARD and other examinations where it is 90 minutes. Paper 2, which contains these 6 subjects, questions from these 6 subjects are asked. In the last year, there were minimal or less number of questions from economics and other areas were very evenly divided, but it might increase in the future. ऐसे just to surprise the students, they might increase it in the future. तो ऐसा नहीं करना है कि economics पढ़ के नहीं गए. You have to study economics and go, because if it is given in the syllabus, it might very well be asked more in depth in the examination. Okay. The good thing is that the entire syllabus is objective in nature other than English descriptive, so you need to study things from a certain particular perspective. The bad thing is that it gets very difficult in objective when you have numericals. Thoda typical ho jata hai, thoda difficult ho sakta hai. And there were a good number of numericals in this year's examination. It might stay the same or even become more difficult in the future as well. Okay. So what are the broad topics in commerce and accountancy? Accounting as a financial information system. Accounting standards, very, very important. Let's mark it. Questions kafi aate hain yahan se. Cash flow statement, fund flow statement, financial statement analysis, ratio analysis, mostly numerical in nature. Accounting to share capital, including bonus and right, ESOP, buyback, and preparation of company final accounts. They might ask you big questions based on journal entries. They might ask you question based on concepts behind all these entries and all this preparation of final accounts in an enterprise. Okay. Commerce and accountancy काफी मुश्किल हो सकता है. मैनेजमेंट, लेट मी समराइज, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन थ्योरी भी बोलते हैं इसको, और इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. सम बुक्स आर कॉल्ड एज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन थ्योरी, सम बुक्स आर बाय द नेम ऑफ प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. सो दिस इज वन विच कवर्स दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया. देन लीडरशिप, कम्युनिकेशन एंड एरियाज हेयर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम मोटिवेशन. Starting from here, this is all organization behavior. To be very honest, they have not given a very good exhaustive syllabus when it comes to phase 2, and they don't follow it very strictly. So if you take the course in the future, don't be worried, because don't think that sir ne to bahut zyada padha diya, because I have to give an introduction, I have to explain a lot of things before actually coming to motivation. So I've taken a different approach, a different structure. This is all human resource development. A lot of students saying human resource management or development is not important anymore. Well, it is given in the syllabus as well. Communication normally forms a part of organization behavior, and then you have a separate subject called as corporate governance. That is also relevant. Kafi achhe questions aate hain wahan se. So that is a part of management. In finance, it is exactly the same as given in RBI. Bilkul same diya gaya. It consists of Indian financial system. It consists of Indian banking system. These are two different things. Please remember and understand this. Banking system and financial system. And then you have regulatory bodies. Okay. And then you have other kinds of topics. For example, public-private partnership, GST, finance commissions, union budget, economic survey, all those things. Those, let's say, we can call it miscellaneous. Corporate governance in the financial sector, normally it is merged with the corporate governance in the banking in management and taught together, but humne alag alag padhaya hua hai thoda sa. The latest provisions regarding corporate governance have been taught there, so this you have to study. Costing mein you have to study a lot of systems, lot of things. Lean system is very important. There were a lot of questions from this area, and this gives you good quality questions. I have divided costing into 3 parts. One is basic, 2 parts. One is basic, one is advanced, and the third is miscellaneous. Okay, so advanced is normally not recommended for SEBI students in my course, but some students want to cover more. They're preparing for other exams also. Ki bhai main SEBI ke liye prepare kar raha hu, let me simultaneously prepare for UPSC also. Let me simultaneously prepare for, let's say, RBI also. Wahan pe costing nahi hai, but even then, so it has been done this way. So you have to cover first the basic areas, which covers the entire syllabus. If you want to cover more topics which are a part of costing but not directly given in the syllabus, you can go to the advanced part. Okay, so you can do that as well. But the minimum that you have to do is try and cover the syllabus of costing. Companies Act specific chapters have been given, and it was very fortunate that they stuck to these chapters. So we are going to be teaching the same chapters only. We will not expand because we feel that they are not going to violate their syllabus here and go haywire with the other chapters, because they've specifically mentioned these chapters. Economics, as I said, divided into macro and micro, both are given here. Demand and supply for money, ISLM, Phillips curve, consumption function, all these form a part of micro, and then you have the macro being mentioned here. Now let's come to the cutoffs. What happened in the cutoffs? In 2020-2021, the examination came in 2020, it was held in 2021. The cutoff in phase 2 for unreserved category was 66, okay? But the final cutoff was 69.24, almost 70%. So to make sure that at least you are scoring 70% to be on the safer side, jab aap mocks de rahe ho, when you're giving mocks, when you're preparing, when you're taking sectional tests or chapter-wise mocks, you have to make sure ki bhai 70 to 80 ke beech mein rehna chahiye, because it might go down in the future as well. My score might go down. So 70 to 80 ka target bana ke chalna hai, that is a safe score. Salary, the last point that we need to talk about is the salary. Let's read this. The pay scale is 28,150, and then all these things are given. It says 73,000 per month with accommodation. So if you're not getting accommodation, you will be paid extra for that. Okay. Presently, the gross emolument, including SEBI's contribution towards NPS, grade allowance, special allowance, DA, family allowance, local allowance, is approximately 1,07,000 per month without accommodation, and 73,000 per month with accommodation. So if you want an HRA, you can take an HRA as well. In that case, you'll be paid approximately 1,07,000 per month. This is the good part about government organizations. You get a lot of benefits. You get a lot of perks. You get leave, fare concession, medical expenses, eye refraction, education allowance, financial dailies, book grants, briefcase, conveyance expenses. This is one where you spend a lot of money regularly. House cleaning allowance. Who gives you house cleaning allowance? Scheme for purchasing computers, lunch facility, and various other perks are provided. So what happens in the end is, out of 73, you end up saving approximately 50,000. Okay, whatever you do, you will be able to spend about 20-25,000 only. Everything else will be saved. So you can either party around with that money, or you can invest it somewhere. Accommodation is normally provided wherever it's available. If you don't want it or if not available, you can take an HRA as well. Okay. Posting ke liye, they have specifically mentioned you can be posted anywhere in India. Aisa nahi hai ki aapko Mumbai hi milega. You can be posted elsewhere as well. Okay. So this was all about SEBI. I hope majority of the queries will now be clarified, will now be resolved with this discussion on everything related to SEBI examination, because the examination is around the corner. So I thought, let's discuss about the basic things related to SEBI. Past year cutoffs are very important. Please keep that in mind. I've already discussed them. 70 to 80 is the time, is the area where you have to lie regularly wherever you are taking mocks. So this was it. In case you have any doubts, you can put them in the comment section below. You can reach out to me. The number for the team is 9999466225. So you can reach out here, or you can write a mail as well at info@anujjindal.in. You can write a mail here as well, and we will be kind enough to respond to that as soon as possible. Okay. All the best, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.